Now we'll keep the object at some other place. So let me draw this. This is my lens, principal axis, optical center, x and y, right? Now I'll keep the object at the focus, right? So I'll keep the object at the f dash. Here I'll be keeping the object, right? When I keep the object at the focus, so what will happen? First of all, I'll consider one parallel ray. I'll have to increase this. And this is our lens. Okay, always like this should be very clear. Object we have to draw, and then we'll consider two rays coming from the object. One definitely from the head of the object, and second we'll have to, like, we have to keep all the rules in our mind, right? Now, so this ray, now first of all, this object AB. Now the ray of light AB, B is object. So D, AD comes, and it is, you know, it is coming, it is parallel to this principal axis, right? So ray of light AD is incident on or falling on the point D, which is parallel to the principal axis. Now after refraction, okay, after refraction, what will happen? It is going to pass through the other focus. So it will pass through the other focus. It is passing through the other focus. Now the second row, second, you know, ray we will consider from here itself, but now it has to pass through the optical center. So now it will be passing through the optical center, and now this are the two rays which we have considered. Again, this is the lens, this is the optical center, this is the principal axis x and y, then this is the object AB. Now we consider that a parallel ray is coming through the top of the object, which is AD. Okay, ray is AD, which is coming from the point A. Now this AD is parallel to the principal axis, and so it will pass through the focus. Second ray, which comes from the A point, it can be so AG and make it as F. So F we cannot take, make it as H. So AG is another ray of light which is coming from the top of the this object, which is passing through the optical center. When it passes through the optical center, it will not deviate, it will pass as it is. Now you can see here these rays were diverging, they were moving apart, but they are here, they are parallel. So here they are parallel to each other. And so we know, we have discussed this thing in mirrors also, like in this case the image will be formed at infinity, and we know this, like when the object is kept at the focus, the image will formed at the infinity. So where the image is formed, children, the image is formed at infinity, right? And which kind of image will be formed? It is actually, it will be beating, so we consider it as real image. Inverted, real images are always inverted. If you all have gone through the rules which I am teaching throughout these lectures, so you'll understand now. So, and it is highly enlarged, right? It will be highly enlarged. Now I cannot draw it because it will be, you know, made somewhere at infinity. It will now, so this is how the second rule formation we have seen, second image formation we have seen. Now what is the, you know, use of all this thing? Now this case is used in magnifying glass, you know, children, it is used in magnifying glass, magnifying lens. Now actually what happens, you know, when we keep that lens, particular magnifying lens, very near, okay, here we consider that focal length is 5, we consider that focal length is 5 centimeter. That means we have kept the object somewhere very, no, maybe 3, right, maybe 4. So it is within the focus, it is within the focus, and in that case we will see very big images, you know, isn't it? If you want to read the newspaper and we use that lens, so what happened, we will see very big images. So in this way, even when we want to see the lines of our hands, and if we use that convex lens, so what will happen? We'll see very enlarged, structure of our hand. So this is how we can understand like where we have to keep the object and what the image formation, how the image formation will take place. In this case, if we consider the focal length to be 5 cm, so again the we have kept the distance as 5 cm only, and you know here. If the focal length is 5, we have kept the object as 3, but where the image formation is taking place, it is beyond f. So it is more than the focal length, like 5, it is more than 5, right? Now we will talk about the third case. Now what is the, this is second case, now we will be discussing about the third case. So please note this, now we will talk about the third case. Now third case, when the object will be kept between M2F and F, right? Now what is 2F actually? See, F is like, see, this is first focus, second focus. Now this distance is focal length, right? When the distance, like suppose phi is the focal length, and now we double that distance, we make it as 10, so that double is 2f, that means when the focal length is double, so it will become 2f. And if you remember, focal length is denoted by small f, whereas here principal focus we are denoting it with capital F, right? So here now we have to keep the object this is the lens principal axis O x and y principal axis, right? So now here what we have to do, we have to keep the object between the, first of all we need to make this f dash, now this is 2f and here also this is 2f. Now if this is 5 cm, then this will be 10 cm, but we are not keeping exactly at 2f, is it? We are not keeping exactly at 2f, so it is between 2f and f, so this is 5 and this exact here it will be 10, but we are not keeping at 10, we are keeping within 10, so it will be somewhere more than 5 and less than 10 distance, centimeter which you talk about, right? So now we will keep the object here, now I am keeping the object here between the f and 2f. Now obviously we need to have a parallel ray which is coming from this side, we have to name the object AB. Now this is a parallel ray which is coming from here, and definitely it is going to, it is a, parallel to principal axis, so it will pass through the other focus, definitely it is going to pass through the other focus. Now the other ray of light we have to take from the optical center, so here it will be formed optical center, and just wait, this is our F and it is going to, so in this way the two rays are intersecting at a point. Now this point is beyond 2f, this is our f, this is our 2f, right? So this is intersecting, these two points are intersecting, but these are, this point is beyond 2f. Again this is a lens, this is optical center, this is a principal axis xy. Now this is the object AB, a ray of light comes from this head of the arrow or head of the object, and this we can name it as AD whatever. This ray AD is parallel to the principal axis, and after refraction it will pass through the focus. Now second ray AE, which is coming through the, passing through the optical center, and it, these two rays are now intersecting at one point. Now we can name this point, right, we can name this point as anything like say G, but this point is the image of this point, so better to keep it as A dash. Now when we draw perpendicular from here, so we'll get the object's image over here. Now which kind of object is, which kind of image is formed, children? See, first of all, it is beyond where it is formed. I will write here beyond 2F, right? It is formed where it is formed, it is formed beyond 2F, right? Then which kind of image is formed? It is real image, it is inverted image, right? Real, inverted, and as you can see, it is larger also. So it is larger than the object, right? It is larger than the object. So this was the third case where the object is kept between the F and 2F, and in this case the image which is formed is beyond 2F. So now we'll go to the fourth one, the fourth case where the object is kept at 2F, right? So object is kept at 2F, where the object is at 2F. O F dash 2F, right? Now when the object is at 2F, again we have to take the straight, you know, array which is coming. Now this is the object AB, ray of light which is parallel, which is coming from the head of the object AB, and it is parallel to the principal axis, and after refraction it will pass through the focus, right? It will pass through the focus. Now second one, which is passing through the optical center, right, which is passing through the optical center, and it will intersect at one point, we'll get one point, right? And this is the point which we have got, and this is the 2F. So the two lines are intersecting at the point 2F, right? And if I draw a perpendicular over here, so it will come like this, right? It is going to come like this, A dash, B dash, and this is 2F. Again, this is the lens, optical center, this is the principal axis. Now this is the object, right? AB is the object, a straight, you know, a parallel ray, a ray comes out from the head of the object which is parallel to the principal axis. Following the rule, this is going to get refracted and it will pass through the focus. Second, which we are passing it through the optical center, these two intersect, you know, and where does it intersect? We get a point A dash, and if we draw perpendicular here, then we get the image, right? I am not able to draw, children, so it is being drawn like this, and A dash, B dash, this is the image which is formed at 2F. This is formed as 2F. So this is how, again at the, you know, and keeping the object at different place, again we have kept the, you know, we have changed the position of the object 2F. So when we keep the object at 2F, the image formation also takes place at the 2F, right? So which kind of image formation has been taken place over here? So it is real, it is inverted, right? It is enlarged, it is of same size. Actually this is of same size, this is very low, you know, so I'm not able to draw here. This is of same size and it is found at, it is formed at 2F only. So this is how the image formation takes place. You know, this, children, this will form exactly when you will draw a notebook here. It is, it, you know, it's like very low, so not able to draw over here, so it has come like this, so not an issue. So this is our fourth condition when the object is kept as 2F, right? First of all, the object was kept where? Between the optical center, between the optical center and focus. Then it was kept, you know, where it was kept? It was kept, you know, beyond, like between the F dash and 2F. Then it was kept, you know, between 2F and F. Here it is kept, where it is kept, children? The second one, it is kept at focus, right? So first one, optical center and the focus, like optical center and the focus, here it is kept at the focus, here it is kept you know, between the focus and the 2F, and then here it is kept at 2F. Now we'll move again further. Now we'll draw the fifth one. Now only two are left. Fifth and sixth two rules are left. Now we'll talk about that. Now we'll talk about the fifth position. Right? Now this is the lens. Now this is the principal axis, optical center, F dash, 2F, F dash, 2F. We are moving that side, isn't it? First of all, here we have kept between the optical center and the focus, then beyond focus, then, you know, like between the 2F and F, then at 2F, then beyond 2F, isn't it? Now we need to keep the object where, children? Now we will keep the object beyond 2F. Now again the same thing, a ray of light comes. We imagine this is A and B object, a ray of light is coming, which after refraction is passing through the focus. And the ray of light which is passing through the center of this optical center is passing, you know, and it is meeting it somewhere, a point we have got. And this point, if I draw the perpendicular, right, it will be A dash, B dash, and this point has come up to where? Between F and 2F. Now try to understand, children, when the object is kept, where the object is kept, object is beyond 2F. It is beyond 2F, right? It is kept beyond 2F. Like suppose if we consider that focal length is 5 cm. So 2F will be 10 centimeter, right? 2F will be 10 centimeter, but still we have not kept the object at 10 centimeter also. Where we have kept? We have kept apart from that, more than that, right? Now, if we have kept the object at 2F, then image formation is like where the image is formed before 2F, isn't it? So the focal length is 5 centimeter, 2F is 10 centimeter. So before 10 centimeter only the image is formed. So it is formed before 2F, or you can even write between F and 2F, right? Between, or you can write between F and 2F. And which kind of image is formed? You can see object is bigger and the image is smaller, and it is inverted also. So inverted image, it is real and it is smaller than the object. Right. So this was our fifth position where the object is kept. Okay. Now we will consider the last image formation ray diagram, last one for the convex lens. Now we have discussed that when the object is at focus, the image formation takes place at infinity. Definitely when the object is at infinity, the image formation will take place at focus. Right. So now this is our lens, x and y is the principal axis, this is O, optical center. Now from somewhere long distance, you know, the ray of light are coming. This is say AB, this is CD, these are the rays of light which is coming through long distance, right? And after refraction, what is happening? It is passing through a point, particularly over here, and this one is also passing, and we find that, you know, these rays are meeting at some place, and this place, so here we can see like AB is a ray of light which is coming from long distance, and it is, you know, falling at here at point B. Similarly, CD is again a ray of light. These two rays are parallel to each other. When the parallel rays are coming from inferior, like when the rays are coming from long distance, they become parallel and they, you know, meet, they intersect at one point. When we try to, you know, draw a perpendicular over here, so this is happening, the image formation is formed, you know, image is forming at focus, and so we can name it as A dash, you know, whatever, A dash, B we have taken over here, so it can be G dash, H dash. So here the image formation is taking place. Now which kind of image is formed, children? It is formed at focus, right? It is very small. It is inverted and rear. So this is how we have discussed the different image formations, right? We have discussed different image formation by keeping the object at different places. Again, we are moving in a particular, particular manner. First of all, it is the distance, the object is bit, here between optical center and the focus. Then it is at the focus. We are moving this way, isn't it? We are moving this way, right? Then the object is between the focus and the F and 2F, right? Here it is on 2F, then beyond 2F, right? And then we have considered it at infinity. Now what are the uses of convex lenses, children? Like why do we use, what is the importance? Why do we need convex lenses? So these lenses are very, very important. Where do I need to write? Okay, so I'll write here uses, or else I'll write here what are the uses of the convex lens. It is used by the palmist as a magnifying glass, isn't it? So it is used as the palmist. It is used in the cameras, telescope, right, spectacles, it is also used in microscope, and in this way these kind of lenses, convex lenses, are also very, very important. And we have to keep it in mind, like where, what are the rules. And just by keeping the rules in my mind, in our mind, we can easily make all the different images. We can understand like where the object has to be kept and where and how, which kind of image will be formed, right? So now this was all with convex lenses. Now we'll move to the rules of the concave lenses and then the image formation of concave lenses, right?